Hi, welcome back to the channel. I am so pumped for this series. So we just wrapped up how to take the best board game photography, but all of that was for creative photography. Now, I want to teach you product slash studio slash pack shop photography, whatever you want to call it. It's taking elevated e-commerce photos for board games. Now with episode one, I wanted to just dive straight into it and talk about the gear, which is why I wanted to separate these videos. So today I want to provide a premise about why product photography is so important and why it matters. That's the same thing. But anyways, how it teaches you to be a better photographer overall, and just some other notes that I wanted to talk about before diving full on into the tutorials straight back to back. Hence why today's video is called a prequel. So why is product photography important? Well, for board games, it is especially important. So think about this for a second. Every single board game needs product photography. Whether someone is launching a Kickstarter, whether they are putting their game on a retail website, in any shape or form of a publisher or independent company needs to sell their game, they need photos of it. Arguably, it is way more important than creative photography. Now, don't get me wrong, creative photography is my favorite and I love it, but ultimately from my experience, companies want product photography because it sells. So more important in like a business aspect, creative photography grabs interest, but product photography is more of a selling point and used not just by publishers, but also by distributors and everyone else down the line, leading you to pick up the board game. So I guess you can say that this series is going to be tailored to those that are maybe aspiring photographers or even experienced photographers, especially in the board gaming niche, because that is going to be my example throughout the entire series. But bottom line is to help you build a portfolio and to hopefully get companies seeing your work and wanting to pay you for your hard-earned work and photos and creativity. I have a really fun finale planned for this series. So either way, if you're mildly interested in photography, I think you should stick around for sure, because the final episode in this series is going to be, it's going to be fun. It's going to be really cool. And you do not want to miss it. So the biggest misconception about product photography, myself included, is that it's easy. You stick a box in front of a wallpaper, snap a photo, call it a day. Wrong. That is 100,000% wrong. Product photography is nowhere near as easy as it looks. It's also 10 times more time consuming than creative photography. And it may look boring, but it's actually very, very fun. The more I did it, the more I've realized that it's actually very entertaining because you're learning every step of the way. Especially when you realize that now you have one canvas. You have zero direction and there is no guide, there is no rule book, there is no instruction manual or tutorial about how you can compose each board game. And as you know, board games are vastly different. Some are just cards, some have meeples, some have giant miniatures, some have boxes that can fit in the palm of your hand, and others can take up the entire table. So there's no board game that will ever photograph the same way, but I am here to teach you the guiding principles that will help you find a better direction to do so. It's crazy, but I think doing a ton of product photography lately has made me better on like the creative side. And I think it's also a very solid training exercise, especially if you are an aspiring photographer, but even as an experienced photographer, it's a skill that I think every single photographer should have. Outside of board games, if you know how to take product photography, it'll help you everywhere, literally everywhere. Doing ring shots and shoe shots for the bride, knowing what colors to recommend to clients, doing portraits at the beach, figuring out how to stage all types of products, like if you're promoting a t-shirt line, knowing how to do product photography for board games, trust me, it's gonna go a long way and it is so worth the investment. Now, there are two other premises that I want to mention. So number one, you do need a camera. Yes, you can do it with a phone, but how would you feel if you hired a photographer and they showed up to your engagement shoot with just their phone? It loses that professionalism instantly, right? And here, you'll be taking photos for clients that are running thousands of dollars worth of Kickstarter campaigns, or you know, each board game that they're selling on their website is $35 up a piece. So if you want to pursue product photography and you know that this is something that you know you're committed to, or maybe like you are very, very interested in photography and you want to push that route into something more of just a hobby, then I really would recommend having a camera Ergo, this series will be geared towards those that do have a camera already, but that doesn't mean if you don't have a camera, you won't learn a thing or two from it. Maybe it'll at least give you an idea of what to expect. However, if you want to see an entry level, maybe like a budget edition of studio photography with a phone and light, let me know down in the comments below. Maybe I can work on something like that. But regardless, the differences will be very, very apparent going from a phone to a DSLR mirrorless camera. And the final premise for today's video, not to put you off from product photography, but rather make you aware, you need a ton of patience for these types of photos. Sometimes you're staging cards and they all fall like a domino effect. It'll make you want to flip the entire table over. You know, other times you're resetting your entire setup for one photo because the shadows that you get from miniatures are very different from the shadows that you get from bags and inserts and everything else. But the light at the end of the tunnel of this series, trust me, you are going to learn a lot. Even if you are mildly interested in photography, like I said, it is a skill that you want to advance. So with that, this series is for you. It's for you to market yourself and to learn how to take professional, clean photos that will drastically enhance your portfolio. That's what this series is intended to do. At the end of the day, creative photos are fun and all, but product photos will be much more likely to land you clients. Plus, who's to say that you can't have, you know, fun taking pictures and make some cash on the side as well. Now, on top of that, when you learn how to take photos like this, that's a YouTube thumbnail. That's a blog post, Instagram story. These super clean photos will help you stand out. And like I said in the beginning, at the end of this series, I have a really fun thing planned in store for everyone to participate in. So with that, I hope you are as excited and as amped for this series as I am. I am stoked to share a ton of knowledge that I have learned. And I'll see you all in episode 1.